What's up, guys? Y'all remember this? This is the hood I had on when I did my VR for Urban Norm. I've had a few questions on how I made it, and I figured since it's almost deer season, I need to get back to working on it and get it out and, oh no, get it out and ready to rock and roll. So, what this is jute and, one of these hunting things made out of gunny sack, you know? Guinea sack. Anyways, and then I just dyed them different colors. It's already camouflage, but then I dyed it different colors on top of that. OD green and black, and I used some tea to dye it. But all it is a hunting mask, one of these. Little fine mesh mask. And you just sew your individual pieces in here. Like, if you look at it up close, this is what it is. It's individual pieces like this. Then there are some stringy things I'll show you how to make. And it's just a bunch of that. See, these are stringy things I was talking about. They're tied in a bundle, and then you just screw them, tie them on. And, yeah, that joker is really nice. I will warn you, they're flammable, so you have to soak them in an anti and stuff to keep them from catching on fire. I didn't do that yet, but that's okay. I'll show you guys. It works really well. It hides you really well. And then I have a shirt that I'm working on. This I just took and spray painted. And it'll eventually be covered from head to toe with camo. Mainly on the back and on the front if I can. And then I have the pants to go with it. And again, I just took some spray paint and some old pants. And you can see a little better on here. You just cut a line in your stuff. And then you just pull the strings out. All the strings that run this way. And then you'll be left with this kind of ropey substance. And yeah. And then you just randomly. It works better if you have a sewing machine. But I was doing this without a sewing machine. That's what it'll look like when you're done. The whole thing. And what you do, you start at the bottom, you work your way up, and these layers, if you can see right here, these layers just lay one, two, and so on and so forth. And then you just continue to do that. And then I just randomly place big long pieces, that way it adds some weight, you know, some depth, because the whole point is to blend in. And if you just have a real heavy, even looking thing, it'll be noticeable. So, you know, you want to cover up your shape, your body shape. But, I had one of these before, and it was not homemade. I bought it, and it was really crappy. So I figured making my own would be better. And for turkey hunting, this is going to be awesome. Be able to sit right in the field directly if I want to, because turkeys don't have that great smell, but they have really good vision. So if I can hide myself totally like this, I'll be good to go. So, I'll show you how I do it a little closer. So the only real tools you're going to need are a pair of scissors. These are not the best in the world, but they'll work. And a needle. Now there's a focus. Alright, the trick with the needle is you want a pretty big eye. And a pretty big needle altogether. Because you don't need it to be super sharp, but you want it to be easy to sew with. It's even better with one of them hook needles, but I don't have that one anymore. So I'll show you how it works. Looks like my cat enjoying it too. One more thing I forgot to show you. Thread, it's important. You could use any color. I just happen to have this dark color. It's like a dark tan. But the important part is this is that sewing machine thread. It's really heavy duty, man. This stuff's a bitch to break. I mean, you got to cut it. Break it. Don't use cross-stitch thread. Cross-stitch thread's too soft and it'll break, but this will work really well. This is what they sew your clothes together with. I don't know the name of it or anything. I just know it works. So, okay, what I'm going to do here is I got this big piece of the stuff. I don't know. You can buy this at Walmart. It's like $7 or $8 if you get it out of season, and I got several of them. They use it for making blinds, and so just cut a square out. I'll show you once I got it cut out. Okay, so I got a square cut out. Now, here's the trick. Let me see if I can film this and do it. But what you want to do is, you know, you want to pull, you'll see it's like weaved together. You want to pull the weave that's running right to left, not up and down. So, once you get the hang of this, it's really easy. It's going to be hard to film it. But you just pull on it and they come out. And save these. Okay? Because I'll show you what you do with these. So let me get some of these pulled out and I'll show you what it looks like as I get them pulled out. Okay? I'll bring you right back. Okay. So now I've pulled all the strings out up to about a little over 2 inches wide up here. You want a little bit of space and I'll show you why in a bit. And it'll look like this. Listen now, the better you can do about not being perfect, the better off it's going to look total. So if you're real picky, it's probably just not a project for you. And I'm going to clarify something right now. This is the first time I've ever made anything like this. I just kind of did a little bit of research on the internet, decided, I think I can do that. So I'm no expert, but this has been working out for me. And what you do is when you're all done, you get Camp Dry, which is a flame retardant, and it keeps it dry, you know, waterproof. It helps waterproof it a little. It makes it water resistant, I should say. And you soak everything in Camp Dry, and that'll help make the flame retardant. But more importantly, it keeps it, it'll help it be water resistant. But more importantly, it's going to help you not catch it on fire. So the next step in your process is, and I'll get... All right, so your next step in the process is to lay it out where you want it. Now, what I do is I do a whole one. Sometimes I do a half one. Sometimes I'm gonna mix it up. But this one is gonna go right here because the next layer is gonna come down over that and cover that up. And I'll show you what I mean in a minute. But anyway, so all you do now is just simply sew this on. I'm not gonna show you how to sew it on. You guys know how to sew. Okay, so it's sewed on. Now I forgot to tell you guys, you need to fold over a little bit of this up at the top here to sew it under, and just sew it across. And boy, you better have a ton of patience when you're making this, because it takes forever. I used my wife's sewing machine to make one to start this when I first started making it, and it screwed up her sewing machine, so don't use your wife's sewing machine. And you don't have to be this particular. I'm just probably being over particular about it. But like I said, you know, I got time, so it's fun. Alright, now I'm going to show you some of the fancy knots, some of these string knots that I call them, that I come up with, and I'll show you how to make these. These are from the scraps, believe it or not. Oh no, well that one's not. These long ones right here are from the scraps, and I'll show you how to make these guys. Okay, these are all the strings that I pulled out from the sideways that, you know, I told you not to throw away. And this is the reason why. What you do is you take these, tie a knot in the top. Okay, now you get this funky, like, little hangy thing. And then you just find the place you want it. You know, and you sew that knot on. Now what I do is I try to keep these out of the actual clothing and dunk these down in some stain and stain them different colors. I even use wood stain in some of them. Work fine. But Ritz dye works real well. Anyways, so that's the process, guys. Takes forever. Maybe one day when I finish, I'll show you. Take care. God bless.